जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी,
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 जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी,
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 यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन,
यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन,
यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन,
यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन,
यमुना तीर वन चारी,
यमुना तीर वन चारी,
यमुना तीर वन चारी,
यमुना तीर वन चारी,
जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी,
जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी,
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare.
Jaya Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Jaya Krishna Balaram.
Jaya Krishna Balaram, Jaya Krishna Balaram. Krishna Balaram, Jai Krishna Balaram.
Jaya Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai, Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai.
Jaya Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai, Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai.
Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Prabhupada.
Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Prabhupada.
Anatimirandasya Jnananjanashalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 रामा राम रामा हरे हरे। भगवद गीता चैप्टर 8 वर्स नंबर 7 तस्मात् सर्वेषु कालेषु माम् अनुस्मर युध्य च मयि अर्पित मनो बुद्धिर् मामेवैश्चस्य संशयः। The meaning of this verse is, therefore, Arjuna, you should always think of me in the form of Krishna and at the same time carry out your prescribed duty of fighting. With your activities dedicated to me and your mind and intelligence fixed on me, you will attain me without doubt. So this verse is very important for all those who are engaged in different material activities. So the instruction given to Arjuna is not that he should stop all his prescribed duties. No. Srila Prabhupada says the Lord does not suggest anything impractical. Rather, Krishna says, Tasmat sarveshu kaleshu mam anusmara. Always think of me. All the time you think of Krishna. That's what Krishna's instruction is. But he also says in this verse, mam anusmara yudhya cha. The cha means and. And at the same time, carry out your prescribed duties or engagement. Normally, people just are concerned with their duties, prescribed duties or engagements. And somebody who is sentimentally attached to some kind of spiritual life, they don't do their prescribed duties. In the name of practicing spiritual life, they become lazy or they are irresponsible. So Krishna is suggesting neither. He is not telling stop all your prescribed duties and simply do remembering Krishna. Neither does he say that you do your prescribed duty. No need to do anything else. He does not say that either. So he says both. You always think of me, at the same time you carry out your prescribed duties. Now how can this be practically done? So Srila Prabhupada says, one can continue one's prescribed duties, at the same time think of Krishna by chanting Hare Krishna. This is the instruction of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given us a very, very practical method of following this instruction of Krishna given in this particular verse. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, if you chant Hare Krishna, you'll be freed from all material contamination. Keto darpana marjanam. And chanting and hearing Hare Krishna also engages the mind and intelligence in Krishna. Because Krishna says here, Mayi arpita mano buddhihi. Mayi arpita mano buddhihi. So, chanting and hearing Hare Krishna engages our mind and intelligence in Krishna consciousness. How is that? If we chant attentively and hear carefully, then our mind and intelligence both are engaged in this activity. It's a completely spiritual activity. This chanting and hearing Hare Krishna is a completely spiritual activity. And right from the time we begin chanting, even before we can properly perfect our chanting and hearing, as soon as we begin chanting, the cleansing starts, the cleansing of the heart. the cleansing of past reactions immediately stops. And it will be complete when we perfect our chanting and hearing. Now, here, one more thing Krishna is telling. Mame vaishyasi asamshayaha. He says, without a doubt, you will attain me. That means a devotee or a person who is engaged in doing his prescribed duties while at the same time dedicated for chanting and hearing Hare Krishna. In this way, person can cleanse his heart and gradually prepare himself to actually transfer himself to Krishna's personal abode at the end of his life. Now, we do not know when we are going to die, but we know for sure death is going to come. That we all know, 100% guarantee, death is going to come, but we don't know when. Therefore, Krishna begins this verse as tasmat sarveshu kaleshu. Therefore, at all times, we engage. Whenever death comes, we are ready. If we practice regularly chanting Hare Krishna. Bhagavad Gita, chapter 8, verse number 8. Abhyasa yoga yuktena chetasa nanya gamina paramam purusham divyam yati partha anuchintayan. The meaning of this verse is, he who meditates on the Supreme Personality of Godhead, his mind constantly engaged in remembering me, undeviated from the path, he, O Partha, Arjuna, is sure to reach me. So, constant engagement of the mind by practicing abhyasa. Abhyasa means here practice. Practice means something we have to do repeatedly, because we are not accustomed yet to think of Krishna. So, it's not an artificial thing. But still, because our mind is habituated to be engaged or absorbed in something material, due to our long contact with this material nature, millions and millions of lives in the past, we have been in this material world. So, that prolonged association has, we have become habituated to always think about something material. So, it's not easy to switch from thinking something material to think of Krishna. Again, thinking of Krishna is not imagining some picture or some form, some painting. No, specifically how to think of Krishna is also specifically taught, that think of Krishna by chanting and hearing Hare Krishna. This is the way to think of Krishna. Now, what happens when we vibrate our tongue and we hear that vibration which we produce by vibrating the tongue, the Hare Krishna mantra? Then our mind gets locked up in this activity of chanting and hearing. Now, chanting and hearing is a completely spiritual activity. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakyam, Atma, Nivedanam. This is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. There are 9 different ways of practicing bhakti, and this is completely transcendental activity. This is completely spiritual activity. So, this way, the first 2 practices among the 9 practices is Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu. Hearing and chanting. Of course, we chant and we hear, but in the beginning, we don't know anything about Hare Krishna. How do we come to know? By hearing from somebody else who knows about it. So, in that way, the beginning or the learning or the introduction to bhakti is beginning with hearing. In the beginning of the 7th chapter also, where Krishna begins to describe Bhakti Yoga, he says, Tat Shunu Yatha Gyasasi Mam Yatha Gyasasi Tat Shunu. Says, hear from me. Arjuna is hearing from Krishna. All the Vedic knowledge is coming down into this world by hearing, Shruti. So hearing is most important. And one more caution that is given is, when we practice chanting, it tends to become mechanical, and because of that, we may not be hearing properly whatever we are chanting. The transcendental sound produced by chanting, we don't hear properly. Or we hear, but not with mind fixed on the sound. So that we have to particularly practice. That practice is mentioned, Abhyasa Yoga Yuktena. Yoga Yuktena means by becoming attached to Krishna in that relationship of devotional service. So chanting is devotional service, devotional activity. That way we get attached to Krishna. And in that connected way, we have to practice this chanting. And in that way, chetasa na anyagamina, you have to practice again, fixing the mind on the sound, consciously chanting and hearing. Consciously chanting and hearing. Chetasa na anyagamina. Paramam purusham divyam yati. You are sure to reach Krishna. Paramam purusham divyam, the transcendental supreme personality of God. Yati, you are able to attain or you are able to reach. Partha anuchintayan, by following this instruction exactly as Krishna is instructed. Anuchintayan, following in the footprints of the great authorities or the supreme authority Krishna. Not manufacturing our own method. Bhagavad Gita, chapter 8, verse number 9. Kavim Puranam Anushasitaram Anoraniyamsam Anusmaredyaha Sarvasya Dhataram Achintya Rupam Aditya Varnam Tamasa Parastar. The meaning of this verse is, one should meditate upon the Supreme Person as the one who knows everything, as he who is the oldest, who is the controller, who is smaller than the smallest, who is the maintainer of everything, who is beyond all material conception, who is inconceivable, who is always a person. He is luminous like the sun, and being transcendental is beyond this material nature. Now, the process of thinking of the Supreme Lord, according to the description, the explanation given by Prabhupada, the suggestion given by Prabhupada, simply by chanting Hare Krishna, you can think of Krishna. But that is the method of bhakti. Here, Krishna is suggesting something for those who are unable to take up the process of bhakti. Why? Because bhakti process demands or requires, not demands, requires that one have faith. Without faith, there is no bhakti. Without shraddha, there is no bhakti. Adau shraddha. Bhakti begins with shraddha. So somebody lacks that faith in the words of Krishna, lacks that faith in the process of bhakti, then such a person may follow this process of thinking of Krishna, thinking of the Supreme. Specifically it said, Supreme. So the foremost point is, the Supreme is the person, not something impersonal or white. Purusham. Purusham means the person, the transcendental person. Divyam. Paramam Purusham Divyam. Divyam means transcendental personality. So he is the Supreme, is the Supreme person. Supreme is the person, transcendental personality. The Supreme is not something void or impersonal. And Prabhupada also says, one cannot meditate on something void or impersonal. So the process of thinking of Krishna is very easy and is factually stated herein. So spiritual personality means Rama or Krishna. Transcendental spiritual personality means, and supreme person means Rama or Krishna. Not something impersonal, something void. No. And described here as Kavim, the beginning of this verse, Kavim. Kavim means he knows everything. How does he know everything? Because he knows the past, present and future. Earlier it was described, the Supreme Lord Krishna knows the past, present and future. And he is the eternal person. So his past, present, future is not related. He knows everything. So therefore, because he knows the past, present and future and he is eternal person, eternally he knows. So therefore he knows it. Then it is also described that he is the oldest personality, Puranam, because he is the origin of everything. He existed before the creation. He remains during the maintenance. And he remains even after everything is destroyed. So he is the oldest person. Now, oldest person doesn't mean he is an old man. Sometimes people speculate or imagine God to be somebody with a big beard. Very, very old. No. Old in the sense that he's been in that position as the Supreme Lord, as the Supreme Person, eternally, always, always. And everybody else is recent, including Brahma, the topmost personality in this universe. So, from Brahma down to the most insignificant creature, everybody is created by the Supreme Lord, by the Supreme. So he is the oldest person and he is also the supreme controller of the universe. That is also indicated by Anushasitaram. He is the supreme controller. Everything is under his control. Though he is in the background, he is not directly asserting himself as the controller by being in front of everyone. No. But he is always in the background as the super soul, as the Supreme Lord Vishnu in his personal abode, in his particular abode. He is also the Garbhodaka Shahi Vishnu, Karanodaka Shahi Vishnu. And he is Kala, like that. He is a universal form. He is present in the form of universal form. So, like that, he is the supreme controller of the universe. He is the maintainer of the whole universe. He is the maintainer of the whole universe. And he is the instructor of humanity. It is he only who gave knowledge to Brahma in the beginning of it. He only gives all knowledge. So like this, the way of thinking of the Supreme is also specifically mentioned in this particular book. I take some questions now. If a devotee commits sinful activities while living in Vrindavan and then dies, then in his next life, he'll be a monkey or a hog and he will stay in the dust of the dham and purify and return to Krishna. Is this correct? Yes. A devotee living in Vrindavan with the aim of doing devotional service to actually attain eternal position of the loving servitor of Krishna. Then he is guaranteed to go back to Godhead. But in case, accidentally, he somehow becomes addicted to some sinful activity, then Krishna is still very kind. If he commit some sinful activity and before death comes, if he corrects himself, still he is eligible to go back to Godhead at the end of that life. But let us say he does not correct himself. He continues his sinful activities even till death comes. And at the time of death also, he does not remember Krishna, but he is absorbed in this sinful activity. At the time of death also. See, please remember that in all cases, Paramatma is active in the heart of everybody, including the devotee in Vrindavan. Paramatma is active in the heart. Paramatma is always giving directions. If we are not conscious of Paramatma, then we don't become conscious. We are not aware. Paramatma is there. He is giving me direction. I simply have to follow him. But I am either forgetful, or I don't care, or I am too busy with what my own plans are. To do some activity, to plan some sense gratification, to do some particular activity. I am in my own world. That is called false ego. Ahankara. Ahankara means I have created my own world around me, around my consciousness. So, I am oblivious to actually what is the reality. I am not giving attention to the fact that Krishna is right in my heart, he is my topmost well-wisher, he is giving me directions. I simply have to take his directions and act accordingly, and I'll be perfectly safe, and I'll be nicely engaged, and I'm guaranteed to return to my original home in the abode of Krishna. All that, I don't care. When I'm busy with my own plans, and my desires, and material activities, and my lording over, and my the sinful ways in which I may act due to not caring for the laws of nature, hook or crook, try to get some gratification for the senses. So like that, even at the time of death, a devotee in Vrindavan does not remember Krishna, does not think of Krishna, does not chant Hare Krishna, does not do any devotional service, does not realize, does not repent. Then next life, he is given a chance. Still Krishna gives him a chance, because he's dying in Vrindavan. So Krishna gives him a chance to take birth in a species in which sense gratification is automatically there. Like lower animals, they don't have the developed consciousness to consciously choose what I should do. Monkeys, hogs, dogs, they are not having that ability by virtue of the birth in that particular species, as a monkey or a hog or a dog. They're not able to think what should I, they're not able to discriminate or choose. So they will be engaged in whatever activity every monkey, every hog, or every dog does. But in Vrindavan, the dust is also completely spiritual. So while doing their usual activities, whatever they are doing, they are actually able to come in contact with the dust of Vrindavan. Not only come in contact, they are also able to take the dust of that Braja Bhumi on their body, and in this way they become purified. They become purified by the dust of the Dham. And of course, they may eat prasadam, they may hear kirtan, they may associate with devotees, so many things. Everything in Vrindavan is spiritual. So, even though they don't have understanding per se in that life, their consciousness is not like, I'm in Vrindavan, very holy, no. But regardless of whether they know it or not, the Vrindavan atmosphere acts. It purifies them. And by purification in that life, they are completely going to become free from all sinful reactions of the past, and they become eligible to go back to God. Next question. Is there any condition, process for installation of DTs at home? Actually, at home, installation of DTs is not recommended. Why? Because when DTs are installed, they have to be taken care, like if parents have a child, how they have to attend all the time to the child. Like that, DTs have to be cared for. So such installation is generally done only in the temple. Temples, every day on scheduled time, aarti, offering, kirtans, prayers, putting the deities to rest, waking up the deities, dressing the deities, bathing the deities, everything happens. So that's why we have not just one devotee, but many devotees. And if one devotee is not able to attend due to whatever reason, then some other devotee will attend. So temple is the place where installation of deity happens and deities are taken care of. And anybody can come to the temple and actually participate. If they cannot worship deity at home or they cannot do offer prayers at home, they can always come to the temple and offer prayers, participate in the worship. They can get educated spiritually. So installation of deities is actually for the temple. Now, it doesn't mean that you cannot install at home. You can install at home. And the procedure is there for installing at home. But we don't recommend, especially in this age and especially under the conditions in which. And above everything, when you got the process of chanting and hearing Hare Krishna, that is actually adequate. That is adequate for you. In addition to that, you can keep a picture of the deity, of the deities in the temple. You can keep a picture and you may offer some flowers, you may offer some incense, you may offer some food. That is okay. Now that picture, there is no rule that you have to worship every day. No. There's no rule like that. Whenever you can, if you are at home, you can worship. Supposing you are going away from home, you are traveling outstation, and then you're not able to worship. That's okay, the picture. But that's not okay when there is installed deity. So instead of installed deity, I would say keep a picture of the deity at home and do the worship. Why did God create the world? And also our final goal is to reach God. If anyway we are meant to go to God, why should God create and then tell you come to me? Why should he do that? Now God is creating this world not because of his desire. He's creating because of our desire. What is our desire? Our desire, everyone in this material world has got a desire to enjoy materially. What does enjoy materially mean? Enjoy materially means enjoy independent of Krishna. Enjoy in forgetfulness of Krishna. Or enjoy becoming envious of Krishna. How we become envious of Krishna? I want to take Krishna's position. I want to enjoy in Krishna's position. That's my imitation. It's like Krishna enjoys rasa dance. Here also, one person will try to have some ball dance with some girlfriends. So what is that business of ball dance with girlfriends? It is nothing but trying to imitate Krishna's rasa dance. Now Krishna's position is that he has got his devotees with whom he is actually engaged in transcendental pastimes. Krishna is not trying to enjoy like us. Don't think Krishna is trying to enjoy like us or we can imitate Krishna. No, we cannot. Krishna's activities are completely in a transcendental platform where there is no compulsion, there is no necessity, there is no force. There is actually only love loving exchange between Krishna and his devotees. Krishna actually wants to satisfy the devotees, and devotees want to please Krishna, and both are engaged like this eternally. That is the spiritual world. So don't mistake, it's a mistake on our part if we think that Krishna is enjoying, why I can't enjoy like Krishna. Actually, we are not denied any pleasure that Krishna is having in the spiritual world also. When we serve Krishna, then Krishna reciprocates by giving us pleasure, which is unlimited. Actually, we are limited beings. So when Krishna gives us unlimited pleasure, we can enjoy as much, we can experience pleasure, relish pleasure, as much as we want and more. Krishna is not denying anything, like what he is experiencing or enjoying. He's not denying us. But if we want to be in Krishna's position, that why everyone should serve Krishna? Why not somebody serve me? Or why not some people serve me? Like they are serving Krishna. That is imitation. That is enviousness of Krishna. So all these reasons, Krishna has to create the material world. And he creates a material world to give us some intelligence for us to realize that we are not meant to be in this world. We are not meant to enjoy like Krishna. We are not meant to enjoy in forgetfulness of Krishna. We realize that. We are supposed to realize that. And for realizing, Krishna has made all arrangements. He is giving us knowledge. He has created the laws of nature. Everything is done. So that's why God creates the world, because of our desire. So I'll stop here. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.